I'm Ratna Bhushan, a friend motivator and guide to IELTS aspirant, international motivational speaker, leadership trainer, CEO, coach, political strategist and policy advisor. Welcome to ASG. ASG believes in quality, commitment and success. A true and non-violent combination of labor would act like a magnet attracting to it all the needed capital. Capitalists would then exist only as the trustees. When that happy day dawned, there would be no difference between the capital and labor. Those who labor will have ample food, good and sanitary dwellings, all the necessary education for their children, ample leisure for education, and proper medical assistance. This is the quote of Mahatma Gandhi from the book, The Words of Gandhi, written by Richard Attenborough. Source of news is the Hindu newspaper. Government bans PUBG, WeChat, Walk, OneRay, 16 other mobile apps. Aim is to protect safety, sovereignty of Indian cyberspace. The government on Wednesday banned 118 applications, a majority being Chinese, including popular ones such as PUBG, WeChat, Work, Baidu, Camcard, Rise of Kingdoms, Lost Crusade, and Alipay, stating that these were the prejudicial to sovereignty and the integrity of India, defense of India, security of state, and public order. This is the addition to the ban on 59 Chinese applications, including TikTok, Sarity, Mi Video Call, Club Factory, and Cam Scanner in June last. Wednesday announcement comes amid renewed tensions between India and China owing to a standoff on the disputed boundary in the Ladakh that has been on since May 2020. In a statement, the government is said this move would be safeguard the interest of the curves of Indian mobile internet users, and the decisions was targeted move to insecure safety, security and sovereignty of Indian cyberspace. The Ministry of Electronics and Information Technology, MeitY, said it was invoking its power under Section 69A of the Information Technology Act, read with the relevant provisions of the Information Technology Procedure and Safeguards of the Blocking of the Access of Information by Public Rules 2009, and in view of emergent nature of threats, has decided to block 118 mobile apps that are engaged in the activities which is prejudicial to sovereignty and integrity of India, defense of India, security of state and public order. A guide to flattening the curve of economic chaos. A guide to flattening the curve of economic chaos. Well thought out politics. Policies can reverse the result of the incompetence. The onus is on the center to spend now. Now it is official. India has managed to become the global leader in the number one of the New Delhi COVID-19 and the worst performing of all major economies during the pandemic so far. How did we manage this double feat? Now through acts of the God, but because of the incompetence and apathy of our current leadership. Victory in a long battle of equal opportunities. Victory in a long battle of equal opportunity. With the grant of the permanent commissions, women officers of the Indian Army will have a clarity on their career path. This year shall be remembered as a landmark in Indian military history for the years to come. The Supreme Court of India on February 17 delivered a much anticipated ruling that allows women to serve as a permanent commission officers in 10 combat support arms and the services of Indian Army. The Supreme Court also directed the central government to rescind the embargo on command appointment for women officer. This July, the government issued formal sanction offering PC to women officers of the Indian Army. This is the culmination of a struggle for equal opportunity that began almost 27 years ago when the Army inducted in the first batches of the women officers in the non-medical corps. Culmination of a struggle. I call the judgment iconic not only because of its allowed women officers equal opportunity to serve in their Indian Army, but also because the judgment addressed the issue of the regressive mindsets. The onus of implementing this change rests with the leadership, but the directions has been shown. The Indian Armed Forces began inducting women in the non-medical branches in the year 1992 as short service commission of officers. The scheme initially allowed for a 5-year service period, which was revised to 14 years. In the armed forces, both men and women opt for the short service commission. However, upon completion of 14 years of service, male officers could get a permanent commission. Women officers who had put in the same number of the years of service were denied this privilege. In a quest for equality, many officers of Indian Army and Indian Air Force, Lieutenant Colonel Seema Singh was one of the first. Seema Singh was one of the first from the army, filed cases in Delhi High Court seeking to remove discrimination between genders. I was one of the petitioners from the Indian Air Force fighting for the permanent commission. Jasmine Kaur versus Union of India, WP. In 2010, the cases was adjudicated in favor of the granting PC to women officers, thus paving the way forward. The Indian Air Force was first among the three services to grant PC to SSC women officer. The Indian Army chose to appeal in the Supreme Court, citing reasons of peculiar service conditions and the operational requirement. A notification of the by the Government of India in 2019 suggests PC to women officers with less than 14 years of service, particularly living in a seizable set of senior women officers out of the gambit. Now with this judgment, women who done the olives of have been fairly obtained parity with their male counterparts. Implications of judgment: with the grant of PC, women officers will now entitled to serving at the age of till the age of retirement and not forced to look for the alternative careers after 14 years. This will provide clarity on their career path and the place women officers on an equal footing with men for promotions, professional growth, and provide job security. Despite forming a relatively minuscule 3.29% of the total strength of the Indian Army, women in all the branches of the Army have served shoulder to shoulder with the male of the officers in operational field areas. The Indian Air Force has almost 13% women officer cadre, 13% women officer cadre, 13% women officer cadre, 13% women officer cadre. The Indian Air Force has almost 13% women in officer cadre. Selection for command appointments of the Indian Army eluded women officers earlier. Now, women officers can be considered for the command roles, career posting, and many other opportunity to distinguish themselves professionally. A grant of PC will accrue many other employee benefits such as an armed service career course, such as National Defence College, College of Defence Management, the Army War College, etc., the Defence Services Staff College, options in higher studies such as Master of Business Administration or Master of Technology, pension, ex-serviceman status, and consequent benefits to name of a few. China using non-military tactics to expand influence. Pentagon report says it is trying to build overseas bases. An annual report from the U.S. Department of Defense to Congress described China leaders' use of tactics sort of armed conflict to further the country's objectives, citing border conflicts with India and Bhutan with examples. The reports also say China is trying to establish stronger base outside the country to so that People's Liberation Army can project military power at the greater distance. Other key conclusion of the U.S. presents include that notion that China's military is at least as advanced as the U.S. in the several country military modernization areas such as shipbuilding, land-based conventional ballistic and cruise missiles, and integrated air defense system. China also uses multilateral organizations to limit criticism of its initiative as per the report. The report describes non-war military activities. Non-war military activities is one of the two kinds of the military operations, the other is war. Used by the PLA, NWMA can be conducted internationally or domestically and encompass activities in multiple domains. NWMA can notably include operations in which the PLA uses coercive threats and for the violence below the level of the armed conflict against the states and other actors to safeguard the PRC's sovereignty and national interest. The report said China calibrates its coercive activities to fall below the threshold to provoking armed conflict with the United States, its allies and partners, or other is Indo-Pacific region. The DOD China Military Power Report 2020. 2020. The tactics are particularly evident in China's pursuit of the territorial and maritime claims in the South and East China Sea, as well as its border with the India and Bhutan. China also employs non-military tools coercively, including economic tools, during the periods of political tension with the countries that China accuses of forming its national and the report, which is its 20th year of the production, the report cites the cities, the role of the People's Armed Forces Maritime Militia, which plays a major role in the coercive operations, including in 2009, the harassment of the USNS Impeccable, conducting normal, and the 2012 Scarborough Reef standoff.